Hello my dear students, welcome for today's video lecture of maths. Yesterday we have started our new chapter number 7, fractions. Okay, and in yesterday's lecture we have learned something about the concept of fraction. You know, fractions means the part of whole. Fraction is related with the parts of whole, and the parts should be equal. When all parts, any object or any figure is divided into equal parts, at that time we can express the shaded parts or unshaded parts in the form of fraction. Okay, equal parts, this is the main principle of fraction. Now see here, in today's lecture we are going to learn something more about fraction. See, here I have drawn some strips which are divided into some equal parts and some parts are shaded. So how to write fraction for the shaded part or unshaded part, that we will learn here. Now see here, in the first figure, if we want to express the first figure in the form of fraction, the figure, the shaded portion of the first figure, if you want to express in the form of fraction, how to express? See here, first count the total parts. In the first strip, the first strip is divided into how many total parts? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. The first strip is divided into total 10 equal parts. Okay, so the total equal parts, right below this line, 10, there are 10 total equal parts. So right below the line. Now we have to write fraction for the shaded part, shaded portion of that strip. So out of 10 equal parts, how many parts are shaded? 1, 2, 3 and 4. Out of 10 equal parts, 4 parts are shaded. So the 4 will be written above the line. Okay. So this 4, here this bar, and here below the bar there is 10. This is the form of fraction for this shaded portion of this strip. Now the question is, how to read this? How to read this? See, this can be read as 4, 10. It is for the number which is above the bar, right, its spelling as it is 4, and the number which is below the bar, right, it in the form of ordinal number, first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, 10th, 11th, 12th, 13th, likewise 10th. Okay, the number which is below the bar, right, in the ordinal form 10th, and the number which is above the bar, right, it as usual. Okay, 4, 10th. This way we can read this. There are another ways also to read. I'll write here. This can be written as 4/10 or 4/10 or 4/10 or 4/10. This can be read as a 4/10 also. Okay. So just, you just keep it in mind, 4/10 or 4/10 or 4/10. Okay. Now this is the fraction, 4/10. This representation is called fraction for this shaded part of this strip. And this, the number which we have written in the spelling, it is called fractional number. It is called fractional number. Means how we read it, it is called fractional number. And this form is called fraction. Okay, fraction, fractional number, 4/10, and the in spelling 4/10, it is fractional number. Okay, see, the second strip is divided into how many equal parts? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It is divided into 10 equal parts, the total equal parts, right below the bar. And out of 10 equal parts, how many parts are shaded? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 parts are shaded. So the fraction for the shaded portion of this strip is 6/10. What? सिक्स टेंथ फ्रैक्शन फॉर द शेडेड पार्ट, शेडेड पोर्शन ऑफ दिस स्ट्रिप, सेकेंड स्ट्रिप इज सिक्स टेंथ. ओके, दिस इज फ्रैक्शन, दिस इज फ्रैक्शनल नंबर. दिस इज वॉट वी कैन से, वॉट वी कैन से दिस फ्रैक्शनल नंबर. And this is fraction. Okay, fraction, and this is fractional number. Understood? See now third one. See third one strip. It is divided into how many equal parts? 4. Okay, and out of 4 equal parts, all 4 parts are shaded. So above the bar also 4. 4 upon 4. Again, if you observe this, you will come to know that out of 4 equal parts, all 4 parts are shaded. That means the whole figure is shaded, complete figure is shaded. So complete means this one strip, complete one strip is shaded. That means what, you know, 4 upon 4 or 4 fourth is equal to 1, because out of 4, 4 parts are shaded, means all 4 parts are shaded. That means complete one strip is shaded. So 4 upon 4 is same as 1. Okay. Then in the fourth strip, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it is divided into 5 equal parts, and out of 5 equal parts, 2 parts are shaded. That is 2/5 portion of the strip is shaded. 2/5. Understood? So here these fractions which we have written, they are for shaded portion of the figure, of the strip. We can write the fraction for unshaded portion also. We can write the fractions for unshaded portion also. Now if 4 upon 10 is the shaded portion, if we want to write fraction for unshaded, means the portion which is the part which is not shaded. Okay, so for that, how to write fraction? In the first strip, if you take the first strip, it is divided into 10 equal parts. The equal parts will remain same, because anyhow it is divided into 10 equal parts. So the number below the bar, it will remain same. Now unshaded parts, we have to write fraction for unshaded parts. So count the parts which are not shaded. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 4 parts are shaded and 6 parts are not shaded. So if you want to write fraction for unshaded parts, write here 6. That is 6/10. Okay, here how many parts are not shaded? Total parts are 10, and the parts which are unshaded are 4. That is 4/10. Here all parts are shaded. Out of 4, 4 parts are shaded, so there is no unshaded portion. In the last, total parts are 5 and 3 parts are unshaded, so that is 3/5. 3/5 portion of that strip, fourth strip, is unshaded. Okay, so this, in this way we can write the fraction for the shaded or unshaded part, and in this way we can read it. This is called fractional number, this is called fraction. Okay, let's solve the practice 7.1, which is based on this concept. This not need to write this, just understand the this is just for to understand the concept. Now see the practice 7.1. Open your textbook, page number 102, practice 7.1. You have to write answers there only. So open it. See, the first question is, write the fraction which represent the shaded portion in each figure. See the first question. If you see here, some figures are given and they are divided into equal parts, and there some parts are shaded, some parts are unshaded. We have to write fraction for the shaded portion. Now see the first figure in your textbook. It is divided into how many equal parts? Downside they have given here box. In that box we have to write fraction. Okay. Question 1 A. The first figure is divided into how many equal parts? That equal parts, right below the bar. See, the box is given, no? Small box. In that, draw the bar. Okay. Count total equal parts. Total parts are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 parts are there. So, that will come below the bar. After that, as we have to write fraction for the shaded parts. So, count shaded parts. 1, 2, 3. 3 parts are shaded. That right up. So, 3/5 is the fraction for the shaded portion. B1. Give here bar. See, here some circles are given. They are equal circles, okay? Count total circles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, 6 will come below the bar. And out of 6 equal circles, how many are shaded? 5 are shaded. So, 5/6. 5/6 is the fraction for that shaded part. Then see, in that box, draw bar, count equal parts, total equal parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There are 7 equal parts, and out of 7, how many are shaded? 4 are shaded, that right up. Okay? So, in this way, we have to write fraction for the shaded portion of the given figure. Question 2, come on the next page, there is question 2. See, question 2, write the fractions which represent the unshaded portion in each figure. Now, here we have to write a fraction for the unshaded portion, okay? So, see here, the box is given there. You have to write there only. In the first circle, it is divided into how many equal parts? 1, 2, 3, 4, 8. It is divided into 8 equal parts. And out of 8, as we have to write here fraction for unshaded portion, the part which is not shaded. So, let's count the unshaded parts. How many are unshaded parts? Out of 8, only 1 is shaded. That means there are 7 unshaded parts. So, write 7 here. 7, 8. Okay? A1, sir. Then B. See this? Square, it is divided into 9 equal parts. And out of 9, again, 1 only shaded. That means 8 are unshaded. C. This rectangle is divided into 10 equal parts. And out of 10, how many are unshaded? 7, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 are unshaded, so 7/10. Understood? Then see question number 3. Write there only. Write the fraction for each of the following. They have given fractional numbers, that is, number names of the fraction. And we have to write fraction for each fractional number. A. I am not writing that fractional number name there. Directly we will write answer here. You just give your equal sign and write fraction for the each fractional number. See the first one, 4/5. So how will you write a fraction for 4/5? 4/5 means 4 upon 5. Right? 4/5 means 4 upon 5. B. Second one is 2/6. 2/6 means 2 upon 6. 2/6. Then C. 3/7. 3/7 means 3 upon 7. In this way. Okay? So, remaining 3, right now only, immediately. Then see question number 4. It's very easy, so we are going quite fast. Write the fractional number for each of the following. Now, they have given fraction and we have to write fractional number. See first one, 2/3. So 2/3, how to write in spelling? How to read 2/3? This the number which is up below the bar, it write in the form of ordinal number 2/3. Okay. Then B1, 3/4. Okay, 3 upon 4. That is how to write 3/4. Number above the bar, write as it is, 3 in spelling, okay? But while writing number below the bar, write it in the form of ordinal number. fourth, not four, fourths, okay? Then see C1, 1 upon 5, that is 1, 5 will be written as a fifth, fifths, okay? Just write S. Understood? So in this way, solve last one also. Okay, now pause this video, write this, solve remaining examples in the question number 3 and 4, okay? After that, we'll see question number 5. See a question number 5. What fraction is present represented by shaded portion of the figure? They have given one figure. Okay, and these parts are shaded. Now see, what fraction is represented by the shaded portion of the figure? So here in this figure, total how many equal parts are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 parts are there, okay? And out of 6, how many parts are shaded? 4. That is 4 sixth, okay? Now, the question is not finished here. See next. Now, the figure is cut as shown below. Now, this figure, where it is, there is dotted line. Along with that, it is cut. It is cut. So, the new figure will be seen in this way. Same figure, it is cut along with this line. So it is cut here. Here it is cut it, okay? So that this part become left hand side and this right hand side. After cutting here, this will be on the left, means this is the another part and this will be separate part. Now, what fraction is represented by the two squares of the left part and one square of the right part? Okay. When we will cut this figure, this will be its left part and this will be its right part. In left part, there are total four parts and in the right part, there are two parts. Now the question is, what fraction are represented by the two squares of the left part? This is left part. If you want to write fraction for the two squares of the left part, what fraction it will be? There are total how many parts in on the left side? There are total four parts. And if you want to write fraction for two parts, then out of four, two. That is 2/4, okay? And for right part, what they are asking for right part? And one square of the right part. On the right side, there are two squares and out of two, one means 1/2, okay? So in this way, we have solved our practice 7.1. Hope you understood this. Write this, complete this in the textbook only. Huh? Tomorrow we will learn one of the activity that I'll tell you. Okay, so thank you for today and have a nice day.